Thank you. There's a thing called epiphany, which feels like you have felt like you have been around God. Tonight, when you leave here, we hope that you will have a theophany experience, that you'll see God. And we pray that you'll have a epiphany experience in which you will feel like you've been in the presence of God. Notable characters in this book of wisdom called by the name of Adam and Eve and Cain and Noah and Jacob and Moses and other persons, Gideon, had experiences with God. Well, tonight, with these fabulous choirs here at the, what do we call it? This is the perennial two-year HBCU college, HBCU college in the world, right here at Coahoma Community College. You may not see God per se or angels, but these choirs are going to come and sing like angels. Somebody say amen. Amen. Welcome to Coahoma Community College. God bless you.
Praise the Lord now. Now he has given me the okay now to talk about the Lord. Amen. See, at first, you know, I'd be trying to act like I got some sense. Tiffany, I'd be trying to act like I got home training, but since I can be myself, praise the Lord, everybody. Okay, let me try that one more time. Praise the Lord, everybody. All right, now with my people. I'm not going to prolong the time. Y'all, we're going to have an amazing time on tonight. We're going to celebrate these young people. Tiff and I were just talking about earlier, you know, oftentimes when we're looking at television or you see the news, you hear all the negative reports about what young people are doing. Y'all, it's amazing, and it feels so good to sit here and see all of our young people dressed up and looking good, doesn't it? Y'all, give them a hand. I'm excited about it. I am excited about it. Well, we're going to get ready, y'all, to receive our first choir, the Jim Hill High School Concert Choir. Don't they look good in their green and black? They do, they do, they do. Let me tell you a little bit about Jim Hill. Under the direction of Miss Pamela Moody, Jim Hill High School Concert Choir is a select group of singers in the 9th through 12th grades. Many of the students come from all over the city of Jackson, Mississippi. They come to attend this school for the International Baccalaureate Academic Program. The choir has a rich tradition of high standards of performance and vibrant, energetic singing that has earned them notoriety across state, regional, national, and international levels. It is the vision of the choir to serve as the best possible musical representatives of Jim Hill High School in whatever performance opportunities they may take part in. Well, for the members of the choir, it is the music that unites them and drives their passion for singing with the hope of bringing joy to those around them. Well, get ready to receive a little joy as we get ready to receive Jim Hill High School Concert Choir.
In the Chelsea's, Gloria, in the Chelsea's, Gloria. Help me, mountain. Said, help me, mount it again, tearing now. Listen, well, I must through the storm. And I must through the rain, and I must through some sickness and some heartache and pain. And I laid on the ground and I looked up at the sky, and I prayed to the Lord up above and asked why. But oh no, I'm not tired, I'm not through marching yet. And I'ma march until I die here in this you can bed. And we'll sing, I'm gonna sing out. And I'm gonna march on. Help me sing, tearing out.
I'm gonna sing out.
Gonna march on.
I'm gonna march on.
Gonna put one foot right in front of the other foot. Yes, I am.
I'm gonna sing.
Well, gonna march on. Said I'm gonna march on.
Oh, well, my granddad fought, and my grandmama too, and I never thought it'd be something I have to do, but I'll march if I must. I'm on a mission, you see, and I'll be damned if I let my children march for me. Yeah, I believe in the power of raising my boys, and I believe in the power of making some noise. If I die, I can't sing. If I can't sing, I'll die. So let's sing for one another. Now let's give it a try. And we'll sing.
I'm gonna sing.
Yeah. Said I gotta
see,
fulfilling the legacy. Wow, if y'all think those children weren't singing, oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Y'all give it up again for Jim Hill High School Concert Choir. Oh my goodness. Up next, we're preparing for Mississippi Valley State University Choir. Y'all, they are looking good. Come on, Valley. Now, the Mississippi Valley State University Department of Choral Activities, the Songbirds of the South, they've been under the baton of outstanding, talented, and dedicated music educators since their inception. The choral department consists of four choirs, the University Choir, the Valley Singers, and two new choirs, which started in spring of 2021, the Valley Men's Glee Club and the Valley Women's Chorale. These are all auditioned ensembles. While the smaller and more select Valley Singers contain approximately 30 singers, the larger ensemble of the University Choir numbers about 70 singers. The purpose of MVSU choral program are to provide a platform for music majors to train to become teachers and instructors, showcase diverse choral repertoire representing a variety of periods and styles, and offer a place for all students to perform a high standard of choral musical, including chamber choir repertoire. Valley Singers serve as a recruiting tool for the university. I'm going to ask everyone to please turn your attention to the monitors.
Hi, my name is Markevion Davis. I am a senior music major from Greenville, Mississippi.
Hi, my name is Adrianika Burge, and I am a graduating music major from the city of Cartersville, Georgia.
Hi, my name is Nia Petty. I am an elementary education major from the city of Indianola, Mississippi.
Hi, my name is Joseph Smith. I'm a music education major coming from the city of Jacksonville, Florida.
Hi, my name is John Brown. I am a senior music major from the city of Atlanta, Georgia.
Hi, my name is Tariana White. I am a senior from Memphis, Tennessee.
Hi, my name is Essence Baggett, and I am a music education major from the city of Indianola, and I serve.
I serve
as the soprano section leader for Mississippi Valley State University Choir.
President of the Mississippi Valley State University Choir.
Soprano section leader and Miss Choir for the Mississippi Valley State University Choir.
Alto section leader for the Mississippi Valley State University Choir.
The bass section leader and the assistant conductor for Mississippi Valley State University Choirs.
Student director, tenor section leader, and Mr. Choir for Mississippi Valley State University Choir.
70th Miss Mississippi Valley State University and assistant conductor for the Mississippi Valley State University Choir.
Good evening and welcome. My name is Dr. Brandon T. Cash, and I happily serve as the director of core activities and assistant professor of music here at the Educational Oasis of the Delta, Mississippi Valley State University. On tonight, you will hear from the Songbirds of the South, the Mississippi Valley State University Choir. I want you to sit back and enjoy as we take you down a musical journey.
Mississippi Valley State University. I want you to sit back and enjoy as we take you down.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the Mississippi Valley State Choir under the direction of Dr. Brandon Cash.
Hello. Good evening, everybody. Good evening. For our first selection, we have Nala Jones, who is a freshman music performance major from Atlanta, Georgia, who will be singing the soprano solo. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you.
On tonight, we have Dr. LaMondra Hamilton, who serves as Assistant Professor of Music and Education, who is accompanying us on the piano tonight. We'll give him a round of applause. Thank you.
Y'all give it up again for Mississippi Valley State University Choir under the direction of Dr. Brandon Cash. Y'all singing, you hear me? Oh my goodness. Y'all, that first little girl that got up there and she was singing, I started trying to test my soprano over here by myself. It wasn't working out the way my soprano set up. But really the way my alto set up too, it didn't. I ain't sounding like none of these kids, none of these kids. So listen, we're gonna get ready, y'all, to receive Alcorn State University Concert Choir. So as Alcorn is making their way, Alcorn, I'm sorry. Oh, they get me straight, didn't they? Lord, can I start over? Can I start over? We're going to get ready to receive Alcorn State. Y'all going to let me be contrary? No, no. So listen, y'all, I was on my way here. And y'all know I'm from Memphis, right? And as I'm driving down 61, I saw a lot of speeding signs, right? In certain areas, you know, they have 65 miles an hour, right? And in some areas, they'll have 60 miles an hour strictly enforced. So as I'm driving down the street, when I said, oh, okay. So when I get to the part that says strictly enforced, I said, okay, I'm gonna drive the speed limit. But when they didn't have that strictly enforced, I figured I'd go as fast as I want, right? Anybody know how can get me out of a ticket? No, I'm just playing. I'm just kidding. I was driving, I said, why is this one strictly enforced, this one not? But okay. Listen, let me tell you a little bit about Alcorn State University. The concert choir at Alcorn State University consists of talented students from across the globe. The choir is proud to incorporate a wide range of styles in their programming and perform frequently throughout Mississippi and the surrounding region. Community service, worship, and a true passion for the art are among the many things that drive the musicians that make up the ASU Concert Choir. Graduates from the Fine Arts Department there at the university have gone on the top graduate programs and successful careers as both educators and performers. Performances include the inauguration of President George W. Bush, Carnegie Hall, and tours of the Midwest. The choir is conducted by Dr. Alona Alexander. Put your hands together for ASU Concert Choir.
The Alcorn State University Concert Choir, under the leadership of Dr. Alona Alexander. Alcorn State University was founded in 1871 in Lorman, Mississippi, on the values of where knowledge and character matter. Housed in the Joyce J. Bolden Fine Arts Building, the Department of Fine Arts, as well as the Concert Choir, includes award-winning faculty and staff, as well as a plethora of amazing students. Coming from different degree programs, the Concert Choir is truly a melting pot of the talented individuals that come through Alcorn State University. The Department of Fine Arts offers majors such as Music Performance Vocal, Music Performance Instrumental, Music Education Vocal, Music Education Instrumental, and the Bachelor's of Arts in Music, just to name a few. The Alcorn State University Concert Choir is truly a home for anyone who will make it. please join me in welcoming the Alcorn State University Concert Choir under the leadership of Dr. Alana Alexander.
Thank you. Father, Father, we don't need to escalate. You see, war is not the answer, 'cause only love can conquer it. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today. Yeah, picket lines and picket signs. Don't punish me with brutality. Talk to me so you can see. Oh, what's going on? What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Mother, mother, everybody thinks we're wrong. Oh, but who are they to judge us simply because our hair is long? You know we've got to find a way to bring some understanding here today. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Picket line and picket sign. Don't punish me with brutality. Come on and talk to me so you can see. Oh, what's going on? What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? Mother, mother.
Put your hands together for all corn. What's going on? I like that. I like that a lot. Well, as we get ready to welcome Rust College, I do want to remind you, Tuesday, y'all, it is election day. Make sure you get out and exercise your right, the right that our forefathers fought for us to vote. So make sure that you go out to the polls on Tuesday and vote. So let me tell you a little bit about Rust College. Rust College a cappella choir is one of America's most renowned ensembles. The broad repertoire performed features literature within the classical, spiritual, opera, contemporary, and traditional gospel genres. This choir has captured the attention of prestigious audiences worldwide, serving as a public relations entity. It has distinguished itself in helping to spread the good news regarding the purpose of the college and its exemplary legacy within the community. The choir has been and still continues to be one of the major ambassadors contributing to the welfare of the college. With its years of accomplishment, it is no doubt that the a cappella choir is vested in the hearts of thousands. I'm going to once again ask that you turn your attention to the monitors.
Greetings, everyone. I'm Joshua Wright, a senior mass communications major hailing from the beautiful city of Clinton, Mississippi. I serve as the 8th Mr. Russ College for the 2022-2023 academic school year. I am also a distinguished member of the Russ College world-renowned a cappella choir. I sing bass, serve as a percussionist, and I serve as an assistant director for the a cappella choir.
Hey, my name is Tyler Harris. I am a freshman at Russ College. I am also Mr. A cappella for the world-renowned Russ College a cappella choir.
Greetings, everyone. I am Heaven Jackson, a graduating senior hailing from Bruce, Mississippi, studying in mass communications. I also serve as the choir president for the 2022-2023 academic school year for the world-renowned Russ a cappella choir.
Hello, I'm Destiny Williams, a senior biology major from South Haven, Mississippi, and I currently serve as the vice president and the alto section leader in the world-renowned Russ College a cappella choir.
Therefore, the Russ College Concert Choir, under the direction of Dr. Harvey.
That's where you fall.
Good evening, good evening, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The next selection will be conducted by one of my conducting students, Mr. Russ College himself, Joshua, and will be led by freshman Tyler Harris.
Lord, I keep so busy praising my Jesus.
Keep so busy praising my Jesus. Keep so busy praising my Jesus. Ain't got time to die.
Cause when I'm ill and sick,
I'm praising my Jesus.
When I'm ill and sick,
I'm praising my Jesus.
When I'm ill and sick,
I'm praising my Jesus. Ain't got time to die.
Cause it takes all of my time.
Oh,
Give it up again for Ross College Acapella Choir. Dr. Harvey, y'all did that. That was awesome. Y'all give it up for them again. All right, y'all, it's time for UAPB, University of Arkansas, Pine Bluff. The University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff Vesper Choir, under the direction of Mr. Jerron Lydell. Bernstein's Chichester Psalms. In March of 2015, the Vesper Choir's annual spring tour took them to New York City with performances at the historic Seventh-day Adventist Church in Greenwich Village, the
His kindness, it spreads o'er us, spreads o'er us.
Thank you. and he blew Daniel. Servant of the Lord. Daniel, Lord.
And the Hebrew nation will give you Daniel what's found, Lord. They put him in a lion's den.
He stayed there all night long.
But the king cried, oh, Daniel,
I'm glad he blew Daniel.
Servant of the Lord.
Now the king in his sleep was troubled, and early in the morning he rose to find God had sent his angel down
to look.
Up, y'all, for UAPB Vesper Choir, University of Arkansas, Pine Bluff. Smokey Norfolk is from Pine Bluff and went to UAPB. I believe he said he was in the Vesper Choir back in the day, and now he is a Grammy Award winner. Y'all give it up again for UAPB. As we get ready, y'all, for Coahoma. I know y'all been waiting, y'all ready. Somebody hollering, woo, y'all really ready, okay. One of Mississippi's well-renowned choirs. The Coahoma Community College Concert Choir maintains an established reputation for performing diverse repertoires, including arranged concert spirituals, contemporary and traditional gospel music with works by composers like Adolphus Hellstork, Robert Shaw, John Rutter, Antonio Vivaldi, Robert Ray, Tom Fetke, Eric Whitaker, and others. The choir dazzles audiences with harmonies fit to stir the soul. As a culture ambassador for the college, the concert choir continues to serve the regional and local audiences, performing at special events both in the sacred and secular spheres. Having toured throughout the United States in major cities from Chicago, Detroit, Atlanta, Orlando, San Antonio, and Houston, to the communities in Mississippi from Clarksdale to the Gulf Coast, the choir reflects the rich legacy of excellence in choral ensemble singing. Singing at the Congressional Black Caucus Foundation Gospel Extravaganza in Washington, D.C., and the Mississippi Choral Directors Association, Mississippi Music Educators Association Conference extended the stages of performance among those known for excellence in choral literature. Put your hands together now for Coahoma Community College Concert Choir under the direction of Dr. Calvin Towers and Assistant Director Jameer O'Carter. We'll be right back.
Hey, what's up, everybody? We are so glad that each of you could join us tonight for our HBCU Choral Festival. We have prepared and we are so excited about bringing you our show tonight. So we hope that you guys enjoy it.
So are you ready for this?
I'm ready.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we present to you the Coahoma Community College Concert Choir.
CBU Now!
This next selection is a very unique piece. It's entitled Dal Dahing, which will be sung in the Tagalog dialect, native of the Philippine Islands. I reached out to the University of Santo Tomas, and I got in contact with the choral arranger there, and he so graciously transcribed this piece for the performance of Coahoma Community College. So without further ado, I will read some of the English translation. My dream came from you. It's your beauty my heart can't forget. Every time I'm with you, all I can feel, how the stars gaze upon your eyes. How happy our love is. I hope this won't change. Ladies and gentlemen, Dal Dahing.
open gar of coal, none will I say, oh, say on gun down a pool, so demon calling more, twing la feeling car, tying a dar of bar, unpassing living, be so emo, young madam, madam. Answer rough, me down by me. Say I'm not in my bar.
You You may talk about the king of Gideon. You may talk about the men of Saul. There's a Michael, no Joshua, at the battle of Jericho.
Joshua beat the battle of Jericho, Jericho, my Lord. Joshua beat the battle of Jericho. Joshua beat the battle, and the walls come tumbling down.
Up to the walls of Jericho, he marched with the spear in hand. He's all called that ram, one Joshua cried, but the battle is in my hand.
Joshua beat the battle of Jericho, Jericho, my Lord. Joshua beat the battle of Jericho.
Joshua beat the battle, and the walls come tumbling down. Then the lamb sheep will begin to blow, the trumpet begin to sound. Then Joshua commanded the children to shout. Tumbling
Dr. Calvin Towers.
I would just like to take this time very briefly, and let me just say it this way. Please don't leave. We have a very special treat coming for you very shortly. You do not want to miss it. Trust me on that. I would like to stand for you to give special remarks. I would just like to take this time to thank Dr. and Mrs. Valmish Towner, our president of the college, our first lady of our institution. They are such proud supporters of our music department. Dr. Towner loved good singing, loved good music, and he's a pastor, so need I say more. We also like to acknowledge our CCC board members. If there are any board members and trustees, please be acknowledged, board members. I see our former president, Dr. Vivian Presley. Thank you for your support. If there will be any elected officials, please stand and just wave your hand to be recognized. And again, the theme has been vote, vote, and vote Tuesday at our polls. I would like to thank our entire Lyceum Committee, Mrs. Yvonne Stanford, Mrs. Rita Hanford, yours truly, and also our Office of Federal Programs for supporting this wonderful event that we presented on this evening. And I would just like to say, no matter how big the task may be, these group of individuals on this committee, we work together. We're a family. We don't complain about anything. We just get together and we just hold our heads up high and do what needs to be done. And I'm just so appreciative for my CCC family here. Thank you, committees. I'd like to give a shout out to our Office of Communication, Mr. Mario Harder, who served as our Chief of Communication Officer, Brother Ezra Howard, and his support staff is up top. Thank you, guys. Thank all of you all and the lady up there as well. Thank you for your contributions to this program. I would like to thank our campus police department, who safely guided all our bus drivers in safely. And I would like to thank the Mississippi Department chapter of the Lynx Incorporated, who serves as our event hostess in the back. Thank you, ladies. Thank you. Wonderful job. I'd like to thank our sound engineer, Brother Travis Calvin, who is a graduate of Coahoma Community College. Very professional, always on time, and we just love him for that. We have some visiting high school choirs here with us. We have Humphreys County Choir under the direction of Brother Justance. Just wave your hand, Humphreys County, where are you? There you go, I see you. We also have some members from Callaway High School in Jackson. Wave your hand, Brother Jamie, in the back there. Clarkston High and Coahoma County is also in the house along with W.A. Higgins. There you go, I see you all. That's home turf, people. I saw as a surprise, Mrs. Latasha Lewis and three of her singers from Rubio Central High School are here. Thank you all, thank you for coming. Now, I'd just like to briefly acknowledge all our performance choirs. We have all the way from Jackson, Mississippi. Let's give a round of applause for Ms. Pamela Moody and the Jim Hill High School Choir. You guys were amazing. I'd like to thank Dr. Brandon Cash and Mississippi Valley State University, my alma mater, Mississippi Valley State University. I'd like to thank Alcorn and Dr. Alana Alexander from Alcorn State University. Those are our friends. We also like to thank Russ College Choir and Dr. Alandro Harvey. We have a lot of Russites in this area in Clarkston, Mississippi. We also like to thank University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff, Mr. Jerron Liddell. Each year we look forward to all of you all coming to our campus each year around this time of the year. And we so graciously thank you for your presence. I'd just like to recognize the members of my staff, my team, our core department. I would just like to acknowledge Lakeitra Smith. This is Crystal Everett. I'd like to acknowledge our accomplice again, Mrs. Jennifer Ringo, who's been with me all of my years here, 19 or 20 years, here we go. And I also like to thank, last but not least, the proud guy that stands is the glue to the in the gun between our program. I'd like to thank our assistant choir director, Mrs. Jamero Carter. I'm wrapping it up, you guys. Our program host, what about the voice of Hallelujah FM, Mrs. Sherry Mackey? Truly a professional now. All right. Well, I'd like to announce our Christmas concert, which will be held December 6th, 7:30 p.m. at St. Elizabeth Catholic Church on Florence Avenue, right here in Clarkston, Mississippi. Our choir, again, will be in concert with the Memphis Chamber Orchestra. You do not want to miss that event. That's December 6th, 7:30 p.m. Admission is free. We have a very special treat for you guys at during our grand finale, a phenomenal soloist. I don't want to even talk about it. I'm just going to let our MC, our host, going to introduce her because I want that Hallelujah FM voice to present our artist of the hour. So at this time, I'm sorry, we've still been transitioning. I would like all our choirs to come to our places. That side, yes, on that corner. UAPB, come through.
As the choirs are coming, I do want to remind you once again that Tuesday is election day, so we want to get out and exercise our right to vote on Tuesday. Also, if you hadn't already done so, I want to encourage you to check out your early morning praise party, Dre Money, Sherry Mackey, on 95.7 Hallelujah FM. You can download the free iHeartRadio app to your smartphone or your tablet, and then take a listen. I think you'll be definitely entertained and inspired. So while the kids are coming, y'all, while the choirs are getting in place, now Dre tells me on the morning show that I can't tell jokes. Uh-oh. She just said do it, y'all. She just said do it. So I'm asking a question. What did the buffalo say to his son before he left for college? What did the buffalo say to his son before he left for college? Bye, son. Y'all get it? Buffalo, bison, bye, son. Y'all know that was funny. Was it good? Are y'all just patriots? You get it? Thank you, baby. Thank you. That was a good one. Okay. Well, let me do another one. Y'all want me to do another one? Okay, all right. What do college students travel in? If the pilgrims traveled on a Mayflower, what do college students travel on? Scholarships. Come on, y'all. Ships, scholarships. You know what? Y'all know. Oh, you know what? Y'all late. Mm-mm, no. Y'all done hurt my feelings. Y'all, they was egging me on. They put me out there. They put me at bad jokes. Oh, they dad jokes. Oops, my bad. All right. Now that the young people are in place, y'all. At this time, we're going to get ready for a memorial tribute in memory of Dr. Michael Bates, the former choral director for UAPB.
Dr. Michael J. Bates joined the faculty of UAPB in 1977 as an assistant professor, initially teaching courses in piano and music theory. Additionally, he accompanied the Vesper Choir under the direction of Professor Shelton McGee. It wasn't until Professor McGee's untimely passing in 1999 that he was asked to take over as director. Initially, he said that he didn't want the job, but he agreed, and after some time, he realized that he didn't want to do anything else. For the next 19 years, Dr. Bates led the Vesper Choir, taking the choir to new heights, two overseas tours, performances in many of the major houses of worship throughout the U.S. and abroad, and securing nearly $1 million in donations just for the choir during his tenure. I first met Dr. Bates when I was in junior high school, when the Vesper Choir sang in my church. I never could have imagined that he'd one day give me the opportunity to sing in that same choir, nor that he'd mentor me during my college career and after, then entrust me and support me to lead the choir upon his retirement. Dr. Bates wasn't just an amazing musician, he was an all-around amazing person. He was one of the kindest people that you'd ever meet, and the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff was tremendously fortunate to have benefited from his expertise for a total of 41 years. Although we mourn his passing, we fondly cherish his memory and celebrate a life that was truly well lived. Thank you.
Check. Would you join me in solidarity? We need to do this in a way we didn't do it in the beginning, and that is to pray. Would you bow your heads and close your eyes for the moment? We're here not for competition, but we're here because God has ordained us to be here. This is a public building, but God is everywhere, hopefully in this building. thank you, Father, for the life of Dr. Bates. We come and readily echo what Job said, that you gave and you have taken away, but blessed be your name. We thank you, Father, for all that you allowed him to do with and through UAPB, there and beyond. We thank you for the lives that he touched. Most importantly, we thank you for touching him. We thank you, Father, for allowing him to be a conductor. But we realize that you are the ultimate conductor, the Alpha and the Omega. We're reminded now as we prepare to depart that the Apostle Paul said that he was ready to be offered up. The time of his departure was at hand. In a Roman jail with a crazy emperor in charge by the name of Nero, Paul knew that his head would be cut off, but yet he said he had a crown. God, no head, but he had a crown. We thank you that we too have a crown that we shall wear. We thank you now for your son, Jesus Christ. We thank you for yourself. We thank you for the indwelling presence of the Holy Spirit. We're not here for show, self-aggrandizement, or vain glory. We're here because you have called us to be here, students, faculty, and staff, members of the community. But most importantly, we come because we are your children. We come near and far. We pray that you'll take us home to our destination safely, and may the remainder of this night our spirits reverberate with the melody and cadence of "We Shall Wear a Crown." When you wake us up in the morning, may we remember we shall wear a crown. When you allow us to walk all day tomorrow in the week, and perhaps months to come, may we be happy that we shall wear a crown. We thank you simply for everything. And we pray now that you'll bless these combined choirs as they come together as a reminder that we shall all sing together as one choir in the great by and by. It is this and all blessing we ask in the strong, stable, stout, and sound name of your Son, Jesus Christ, we pray, and all the people affirm by saying amen. Amen. I know you don't want me to sing.
Thank you so much. Well, Dr. Towner, Lady Towner, and all of our guests and friends, this next young lady, your guest vocalist, is not just a nationally renowned artist. Her gift from God, her anointed vocals, have taken her literally all over the world. She is an internationally renowned vocal powerhouse. She is Lady Tiffany Mosley. So put your hands together now for the Jim Hill School Choir, Alcorn State University, Mississippi Valley State University Choir, Reps College Concert Choir, University of Arkansas Pine Bluff Vesper Choir, Coahoma Community College Concert Choir, and me, Tiffany Mosley!
I shall wear a crown. I shall wear a crown.
I shall see his face, his face. I shall see his face, face. Tell the story.
Now I know we here in church, you know, I feel churchy if you don't know. You told me I can feel like I'm at home. I just have a question. Are any of you really saved? Do any of you really love the Lord? Hallelujah. I just want to see the hands of everybody out here. You really love the Lord. Hallelujah. Don't you ever just sing love songs to the Lord. I'm going to give you a second to just go ahead and tell him something you haven't said to him all day. Tell him how much you love him. Tell him thank you. If you don't know what to say, just say his name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Woo. Thank you, Lord.
Yeah.
Thank you.